It's a basic requirement of due process in a criminal case that the prosecution must prove each element of a charged offense beyond a reasonable doubt. Is it constitutionally permissible for a trial court to instruct a jury that, if the prosecution proves a certain predicate fact, the jury must presume the existence of an element unless the defendant rebuts the presumption? The United States Supreme Court addressed this issue in Francis v. Franklin. Raymond Franklin, a jail inmate, escaped from custody while he was being treated at a local dentist's office. He grabbed a guard's pistol and fled with a dental assistant as his hostage. They went to a nearby neighborhood where Franklin banged on Claude Collie's front door. Collie opened the door, and Franklin demanded keys to his car. When Collie slammed the door, Franklin shot through the door, fatally hitting Collie in the chest. After Franklin eventually was arrested, he claimed that he accidentally shot through the door after Collie slammed it. Franklin was charged with capital murder and kidnapping in state court. At his jury trial, he asserted that he didn't intend to kill Collie, which, if believed by jurors, would have been a defense to the capital murder charge. The trial court instructed jurors that, quote, a person of sound mind and discretion is presumed to intend the natural and probable consequences of his acts, but the presumption may be rebutted, unquote. The jury convicted Franklin of capital murder and kidnapping and sentenced him to death. On appeal, the Georgia Supreme Court affirmed his convictions and sentence. Franklin then filed a state habeas corpus petition, which was denied by the state courts, followed by a federal habeas corpus petition. His federal petition alleged that the trial court violated due process by instructing the jury on the presumption concerning his intent. After the federal district court denied his petition, the United States Court of Appeals for the 11th Circuit reversed the district court's judgment. Robert Francis, the warden of Franklin's prison, successfully petitioned the United States Supreme Court to review Franklin's case.